We went to Wheaton College. He was a really good athlete. I knew, you know, he had a lot of friends and he was well respected. I always wondered if I'd ever get married because I'm a very strong person, and I could never imagine someone who would be strong enough to stand up to me at times and yet willing to yield on other things, and it made our marriage work pretty well. As a dad, he was, I always told him, I said, you know, I may complain about, you know, our relationship sometimes or get on your back about things because that's what happens in marriages, but I can't think of a time I ever complained about the kind of dad he was. He was just real involved with his kids, and he loved them. And the minute he walked in the door, from the minute he walked out the door again, he was willing to invest all his time into what they wanted to do.
Dave, do you want another kiss for Daddy? Say happy birthday, kiss Dad.
Todd had the experience growing up with Christian parents and having the story of Jesus introduced to him at a very early age. And you know, when he was a young child, he made a decision that Jesus was not only for his parents and for his family, but it was for him too. And I think throughout his growing up in junior high and high school and college, it became a process of learning how Jesus could walk with him every day and affect his decisions every day. A lot of people talk right now, just because of the world situation, about faith and about, you know, turning to God, but that wasn't something Todd turned to at the last minute because he didn't know what else to do. He really tried every day to make decisions that would lead him closer to God and closer to what God wanted for him.
Federal investigators say 32-year-old Todd Beamer helped overpower the hijackers on United Flight 93. The plane, which crashed into a Pennsylvania field, may have been bound for the United States Capitol.
I didn't know what Todd's role was for 3 days. I knew what had happened on the flight. I knew the passengers had staged an uprising, but I didn't have any specific information on what Todd did. And a lot of people during that time said, what do you think happened? Do you think Todd was involved? And I said, yeah, I'm sure Todd was involved. You know, he was a courageous guy, and he was a competitor, and he was someone who certainly wouldn't let someone hurt him or himself without doing something about it. And obviously I knew that Todd's perspective would have been knowing that even if he wasn't going to come out of this, that this wasn't the end for him, it was just the beginning.
We have seen it in the courage of passengers who rushed terrorists to save others on the ground. Passengers like an exceptional man named Todd Beamer. And would you please help me welcome his wife, Lisa Beamer, here tonight.
Oh, it's been a great source of encouragement for me. I've had so many people come up or email me or call me and say, you know, I was on the Capitol steps that day, or my son works at the White House, or different people just specifically. I was actually at the White House yesterday and had numerous staff people come up and just shake my hand and say thank you. And, you know, I know in so many ways that Todd's death was not in vain, but to be able to look at people who really feel like they owe their life to him is a unique blessing. I mean, there's so many ways for people to die, and I feel like you know, God really blessed Todd by giving him something so valiant to fight for at the end. And the other piece that Todd did that was unique that we know about, I mean, we don't know what other people did, but Todd asked that operator to pray the Lord's Prayer with him. Now, as I was thinking through the Lord's Prayer, the biggest piece that stuck out to me is the part about asking God to forgive your trespassers as you forgive those who trespass against you. And I just thought, man, Todd was asking forgiveness for these people at the time, and I don't know, you know, if that whole thought was going through his head, but it's certainly something for me. You know, I haven't even really thought about, you know, the anger and all that goes along with the whole thing for me, as far as what those people did to Todd and how they, you know, destroyed my family here on earth. But Todd at that time was able to have the presence of mind to say, you know what, God's going to forgive these people, and I need to forgive them too. And that piece was just really big for me to look at and say, good example, Todd. I'm going to try my best to pick it up from there and do the same.
This has been a terrible week with many tears, but also it's been a week of great faith.
I just think that our nation has been a little bit awakened to the fact that life isn't all about, you know, making money and you know, being successful and even being happy. But it goes a lot deeper than that, and I hope that people just use this opportunity when Obviously, everyone's got to be thinking about the bigger picture right now, because everyone's security, whether you were touched personally or not, has been shaken by this. And my advice to people would just be to look deep inside and ask the tough questions as far as, you know, if you were taught on that plane, what would you have done? If you were sitting in my chair right now, what would your perspective be? And would you be able to just have the eternal hope that I have? And if you can't, then I ask you to sit down and open your Bible and ask God to show you. You know, last week and this week have just been such extremes of pain and joy that I can't even explain to you, obviously, how deep my pain is, but also how great my joy is in being able to know and being able to show the world who Todd was, but also being able to, more importantly, have Todd's example and hopefully my example and my reaction to this whole thing just be a light for people. And, you know, God's just given us both an amazing venue right now to share why we're here and what our perspective is and how it's different because we know him.
Look, he spins. Can you make him spin? Yeah, there he goes.
You know, I can deal with things that are coming up in 5 minutes right now. I can deal with thinking of eternity with God and certainly, you know, looking forward to seeing Todd again someday. But, you know, when I look at all those years in between right now, it's overwhelming to me and all the, you know, the tasks of raising my sons and those things and the loss is impossible for me to deal with right now. But being able to have that eternal perspective, I just keep saying to myself when I start to think, oh, you know, this isn't going to be the same or what about this, I just say, look up, look up. That's why I'm able to sit here right now and talk to you. Because if I did not have that big picture hope, I'd probably be up in my bed right now. That's the mantra that I've kind of been running through my head. Just look up and look at God and look at the hope that you have in him.